Well, we're here at the shop, and the first thing we see is Dave's beautiful car. Jesus. Guy's got a boat, wooden boat, just like Susanna, and a car, in a way, very similar to mine. Except mine doesn't have an engine. It still has old technology, an engine. Guys, we're back on top with Clint.
Back up.
Wow, look at this, the deck is back up. All right, so you're fitting the windlass.
Yep, it's exciting drilling a 5 1/4 inch hole. When they get that big, you gotta run the hole saw backwards.
We're putting stuff back together.
Putting stuff back together. Wow, how great. What a great feeling. Oh, dude, look.
Ceiling planks going in.
Look at that.
4 feet.
Well, you were right, the El Nino.
I'm always right. Nobody listens to me.
Well, the world now will know, Doug, we're gonna go back, and he predicted this weather.
It's the 11-year solar cycle.
Cyclops is here.
Back.
He's back. Ah, there she is. Hello, Doug.
Good morning.
We about to have lunch?
Already ate.
You already ate?
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, well, I mean, you started at 4:30.
Well, you started at 4:30.
Please note the floor space.
Ah, yes.
The hall has been sanded and sealed.
Oh, we'll go through the whole thing for sure. Look at that. Look, she looks beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All lines marked. Shutters are fixed.
Beautiful. And, nice day. You got your jacket on. Are you heading out?
No.
It's just cool in here, yeah.
Cold.
Cold, damn cold.
Damp.
What's going on with the thin damp? Yes, yes. Well, you were right, the El Nino.
I'm always right.
Really? Really? Couldn't we have some compromise?
Nobody listens to me.
Well, the world now will know, Doug, we're going to go back, and he predicted this weather.
It's the 11-year solar cycle. You got more coming Saturday and another one Wednesday and Thursday.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. Are we into a home stretch? Beautiful she looks, guys. All right, so you're fitting the windlass.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like you're working on the windlass area.
Yep, it's exciting drilling a 5 1/4 inch hole. When they get that big, you gotta run the hole saw backwards.
The what kind of saw?
The hole saw.
The hole saw backwards.
You know, tweak you wouldn't believe.
But how big of a drill bit do you use for that?
That's how big it is.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And that's what you need. That just puts you to an eighth or something.
So you actually had to have a drill bit that size?
Mm-hmm.
That wasn't just worked?
Nope. Okay.
So is it a bit or a cutter? We'll take a look at that later.
Yeah, it's a big old hole saw.
All right, so look, you're fitting these sleeves. This is gonna be for the chain.
This is for the chain.
See how smart I am?
Our first try.
Our first try, wow.
I'm getting this stuff, by the way.
You went out and bought this stuff in town?
Look at that. That's a beautiful angle. See it?
I can't really see it. Oh yeah, look at that. Yeah.
It's gonna go down through that bulkhead and into the chain locker.
Yep.
That is just about perfect.
Okay.
See, now this one, see, it has to go on here. And not only the angle, but the height and the distance was very critical. Of course, it's too long now.
But
it's a direct hole. So you'll eventually go through like this.
Right.
Isn't that beautiful?
Does it matter which way it lines up inside the tube with the leading edge?
No.
Creating some extra drag? Is it better
to
have?
No, because see, the way PVC is.
Oh, it tucks into that space.
Yeah, it's pretty smooth inside. I was gonna go with 2.5 inch.
Right.
And I have a sample piece down there, but I looked at it and I went,
This is 2 inch?
This is 3 inch.
This is 3 inch.
Okay. See how it is?
Yeah, we need a piece of chain, don't we? Especially with the shackle at the end, so we know the shackle will go through.
Well, that's the thing. Well, there's not gonna be a shackle.
It's just gonna be solid chain.
Yeah. And even if you had a shackle, this would probably work.
No, but I don't want all chain. We want to go to rope.
Yeah,
some rope at the end.
No.
No?
Not
100%,
out here.
100% chain?
200 feet.
200 feet? Okay, cut. All right, so where are we? What are we doing here?
We're putting stuff back together.
Putting stuff back together. Wow, how great. What a great feeling. Oh, dude, look.
Ceiling planks going in.
Look at that.
4 feet.
It's all going in. Everything back in. Nice.
Just doing what I can.
And these, yeah.
Dave's doing his wiring right now, so.
Okay.
Some things are staying out while he's finishing his wiring up, but the things that I can put in are being installed right now.
So that's the 4 peak. What about that bottom, that plastic thing?
That's going to be the chain locker and stuff in there. We're not doing that right now. We're going to focus on
getting
the stuff that we can in. And
look, it looks great. It's going back in easy, no problems.
No, everything's going back in. Everything was numbered and
right,
and it's already been installed. So when we put ceiling planks back in, everything sets itself back in the same hole, so.
Perfect.
Goes good. We got these new face frames. These are.
Oh, look at those are in.
These are installed and glued.
That's great. Let's check it out. Close that door. So that's with the old doors.
The original
doors from another cabinet.
Yeah.
And installed into a new piece.
Mm-hmm. So the new face frame right here, glued and
right.
Use these old doors here.
Great. They fit nice. They close nice.
Oh, yeah. Everything's.
And then what do you have inside there? You have
put a shelf in there. Little, right, and this is all removable right here. You can take it up from the top. And then,
beautiful.
Sanded out the aluminum here.
Oh, and we can see how the closet came out. And
yeah, this is where the old closet was right here.
Right.
So we utilized that notch for these new face frames.
Beautiful. And then look at that. Let's check that detail. It looks really, really nice. Now these were, is that a gloss finish on there?
Yeah, just like these.
Oh, just to match those.
Yeah, just to match them.
Gotcha.
And we sanded all the metal down.
Oh, beautiful. Feels great.
Sanded most of the scratches out. You couldn't get all of it, but then we put a satin finish spray on there to keep it pretty nice there.
Great. So that's the back wall there. We'll still have to put the shelf in.
Right? This gets blocked in and shelves and all that good stuff. Of course, our new bunk supports.
You know, nobody's really seen the boat. Like even originally, like I didn't have a whole walkthrough before we took it out.
Oh, before we tore all that old stuff out?
Yeah, I'll have to go look. Maybe we do, we'll have to look back. But, you know, the idea is that it looks very similar, but all fresh and new and you know, solid now.
Yeah,
it seems great.
Sweet.
So, that's great.
Coming together nicely.
And, all right, so that's moving backwards.
So this is gonna get installed today. This is the base for the sink.
So we redid all this. This used to be an old ice box that was jury-rigged with a little compressor unit. Now it's
built
gonna
in.
Be a,
remember how it was built in?
Yeah, yeah. So well, for years it was just an ice block holder.
Tore all that out, made it new. We were able to save the old corner post here.
Right.
We cleaned that up and you can take a shot straight down and see this is all new here.
So that's the original corner post.
Yep.
New fascia.
Mm-hmm.
New.
All that's brand new in there.
But you're going to use the original top, which you just brought up.
No, this is a new top.
Oh, a new sub.
This is a new sub top here.
New sub top.
And that's going to go down like that, get screwed down. And then the sink obviously goes on
the top of the sink, which you've got right here.
Mm-hmm. That's going to mount on top
of there. That's right there.
Dave's got all his wiring, so I gotta check with him before we put any.
What do we got?
Install this to make sure he's got his wiring.
Oh, he's got access.
And there's your new gas line right here that's gonna go into the stove.
Great. Beautiful. And of course, the new The new look, all brand new in here. With the old cabinet doors.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
So the old doors. We used the old doors and made all new face frame shelves.
Yep. Nice and solid. Again, original doors, which is what we like.
Got our handy lights on here.
What's that?
Got our handy lights going here.
Yeah. Good. Okay, sir, so what are you doing here?
Nothing.
Is that the water fan?
Are you exhausted? What?
I'm going, what was I doing here? this will require a little bit of engineering.
Okay.
See, what I'm trying to do here is you want to make this semi-removable.
Okay.
With minimal amount of tools.
Okay.
In other words, if we put this in and you tried to crawl up in here, it'd have to be this tall
with a voice like this.
Yeah, so you couldn't do it. So
I see.
You don't go up here and hang out.
Well, what's up, what's gonna be up under here anyway?
Nothing.
Nothing, a little power or anything? No.
You might throw a couple fenders up here, light stuff.
Just wedge stuff up here. Yeah.
Light stuff.
Yeah.
That's impervious to water, like fenders and
right.
Because you want to keep the ends of the boat light.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, by putting 1,000 pounds of chain right there.
12 feet behind the stem.
Is that okay?
Instead of right here.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. True. True.
So down far back and as low as possible. That's what we've accomplished. So.
Okay.
This coupling here is a tapered thread. So once you tighten this, you're not going to get it out.
And why is it a tapered thread?
Well, so it'll be watertight, which we don't care
beautiful.
About. This is stainless, by the way, so it's not gonna rust.
So we don't care really about it because we've got drains and a little bit of water dripping out of there.
It's believe me, none of it's coming out of this pipe.
None of it's coming out of this
pipe. Because the joints are all gonna be glued. The theory being that you can unthread this and pull it out.
If you need it to.
If you need
to. To clean or to.
Well, just to get up in here.
Oh, just to get up in here, right.
You don't ever want to build a wherever possible, don't want to build in a boat where you can't get your body or at least access.
Didn't we talk about it swinging away, possibly? Just like twisting away? You could just undo it from one end and then just twist it away?
We did, but the problem with that was that it was going to be a mess in the V-berth.
Okay.
Something else to remember.
Yeah.
At 2 in the morning when it's blowing 45
swing it
knots.
Back.
Yeah. This is semi-permanent so that you... You just raise the anchor, you lower the anchor. That's it. And you don't worry about it.
Right. Say that again. You need to put a little piece of pipe in.
Yeah. See how high it's hitting on the bulkhead.
Yeah.
We want that to drop down about 6 or 8 inches.
Because we want to go underneath.
We're
going to punch a hole in that bulkhead.
Right.
Roger that.
10-4.
Okay.
Now.
No, so. Not coming in above that hole. No, you're going in.
Yeah. Just go. Oops. Sorry. Go.
Show us where we're
going. Go straight down with it like it's.
Okay, let go.
Yeah. Ooh, okay, come back up. Looks like about.
4 inches? 5 inches?
A little more than that. Well, 7 or 8.
7-8 inches?
Okay, now let's see here.
That's what she said.
You might not even need this coupling, I don't know. You're never gonna crank this down tight, you know what I'm saying? It's just gonna be kind of sitting in there.
Okay.
But,
Roger.
It's so tempting to yell. No, other way. I think. I'm not sure. There you go.
You have it like this?
Yeah. So with that coupling and a short piece of pipe, just enough to make the connection.
Yeah.
Oh, baby.
See that?
This angle here, are we going to have a just sweep in more?
Well, see, they both have a straight section.
Mm-hmm.
So this should emerge through the bulkhead about right here. Is it? Yeah. Got a tape measure on you?
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's as low as possible, just straight, 45 roughly. See, now this is a 5.5-inch hole saw.
Okay.
Anything over about 2.5 inches or so, you gotta be very careful because there's a lot of torque. And that Milwaukee drill will turn you around and hurt you. So, when you're doing a really big hole, all you aspiring boat builders, run it backwards.
Oh, so that it still cuts, it just cuts. Not as much.
It cuts slowly, but it won't kill you.
It more just cuts with friction.
Well, the teeth are backwards, and okay. It's not the best thing, but when they get over about 3.5 inches, here we go.
All
right, thank
you.
Yeah.
Do it upside down.
Yep.
Like that.
Now, if it, there you go, as low as possible. Yeah, let the whole.
We got stuff laying on here. I can't go right up against there. We got.
No, we're going to cut those.
Really?
Oh, yeah, we're going to have to, remember?
Okay.
Because what we'll eventually do is box that in. Deeper angle if you can.
That's about it right there.
Okay.
Set that back real quick.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Clean house.
Oh, yeah. Well, we might as well try our... Put this in, let's see.
First.
Yeah. Connect them and then we can...
Yeah. All right, they're connected.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah, this is centered. I can center this inner way. It'll just be offset, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Well, obviously, because we have the hole offset in that.
Yep. So.
Right, that's it right there.
Thing. See, what we can do now is we got plenty of fall and all that's good.
Yeah.
Also, when it enters the locker,
yeah,
it falls again. So what we should do is just see how the chain works.
Okay, yeah.
If it piles nicely, we're good. If it doesn't, after you actually have the real chain, we can add 6 inches or a foot to the end of that so it dumps further down into the locker. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Because the angles are all good now. It's all good.
Hey, so screwing, this is getting its permanent installation now?
Yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Screwing her down, putting a little wax on the screws. Been a while.
Yeah, you guys made this thing months and months ago.
Yeah.
A year ago?
At least. At least.
Back together like a kit, like Doug said.
Oh, yeah. Everything's going back how we planned.
Nice. Doug said he couldn't find like the edging for a while.
Oh, that piece right there.
It's hiding.
It's hiding. I couldn't find this piece. I looked everywhere in the shop, I couldn't find it. And I pulled the water tank. Of course, it was down in the bilge under the water tank. Oh. I didn't throw that away.
Of course, nothing gets thrown away, right? You know that.
Yeah.
And my wife says, "You sure you didn't throw it away?" No, I know I didn't. All right, so you got that last one countersunk?
Oh yeah. Let's get the sink. I want these perfectly.
Of course.
Not too deep, but just fairly under, so. Off here.
And what's the tape for?
When we bed this, mm-hmm. you get some white Sikaflex around the edge.
Okay. I see. So you're going to put
kind
some
seals
some,
it.
Something down between the.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Just pretty much on the edges here.
Gotcha.
In case water ever got behind there. Not that it would do anything, but it's always good to seal your work up.
Okay. And so that's just a protective varnish.
Yeah.
Okay. Very nice.
All the wood's been sealed. Definitely not gonna. Water definitely not hurt it, but it's just something.
Chris,
yes, sir.
You need some Sikaflex?
Yes.
Okay, I think they have, so I'm gonna run down there. Just one tube?
Uh-huh.
Okay. I have to get some bushes for this.
Where are you heading to?
This is probably the greenest car within a 100-mile radius. Because it's 31 years old.
Right.
Which means it's been recycled 3 times. Oh, if the car lasts 10 years.
Right, right.
Provides the jobs,
yeah.
Buying parts and labor. Was getting 28 something miles a gallon for 30 years.
Right.
Before everybody was talking about it. Think about it. Way ahead of its time. I finally got washed yesterday. I drove in the rain.
Sure.
Going to Avenue Harbor, opened in 1931. One of the last old-time hardware stores that still has everything. You know, if you want a machete, they're next to the guitars. You know, that kind of store.
Yesterday.
I need 3/8, like some plastic pipe or something. Oh, ID.
What, FBI? Checking
this
out.
Is the CIA.
Yeah.
What I'm looking for is like a spacers. Like
right.
I don't know, some kind of PVC or plastic.
How long do they need to be?
1 inch.
Okay, I got them. Let me think about them.
Got them.
They're either in front or in the back.
Mm-hmm.
I think they're going to be in the back.
Okay.
Gillette. You just gotta make something work, huh?
Yeah, we can. So we can cut it, do anything we want. It's mainly just to take up the slop. Yes.
Well, let's see how this looks as far as. There, or. How about a. That's too small, isn't it?
Too small.
And then you'd have to go to. Wow.
Too big.
You
need a Goldilocks
one. They
it could be plastic, Jim.
Is that the piece you're using right there? That's the size?
Yeah, this is it. Too big. From there to there.
Oh. Okay.
Have some stuff.
Thank you.
Like,
good. Excellent. Now.
That right there.
I'm about a year old.
That's a million of them.
Have some,
that's 5/8 on the outside, though.
Okay.
You want 3/4, right?
Yep.
Okay. I asked them when.
Hold on.
It's almost 3/4.
Hey, Jim, the cheap seats, please. Is this
it's almost 3/4. It's about 11. It's about 11/16. It's a mal. What is that? It's a weldable coupling.
What's that? Just ferrous?
Yeah.
Oh. You know what?
A little rustling.
Yeah, where it's going, we need to. You know what they can do here? A little reverse engineering. We'll just cut it over an inch so that when I tighten it, it'll compress it. So give me about that much. You don't need. It's crazy what you need, but.
You're saying that will work. That'll work pretty nicely.
Well, because if I cut it an eighth inch or so too long, when we tighten
it, and squeeze it, it comes.
Yeah, it's almost 3/4 now. There you go.
That's a good idea.
That's plenty. Okay, good. All right. Well, there's that Suzuki. Yeah, we got what we needed. Here he is.
Back to the beast.
Yep.
Okay, we're on the air.
All right. Well, this is the windlass part of it. There's a lot to it. I made this pattern because you remember when we were up on deck? There's a deck beam right here. And this wants to be oriented about 2 or so inches off from dead center so that when the chain feeds around the cat, it stays on the cat and it goes down the pipe. So we had to make this pattern to make sure that when we bored the holes, all this lined up and so forth. You can't really do it with that. And so that we didn't cut through any of the deck beams. It's all about the blocking.
Gotcha.
Because these bolts will then sandwich the blocking and the deck, and the deck beam, everything all together with the plate underneath. So that's the pattern that we made for it. And
this is the new windlass?
Yep.
And that's the part
that's only about 12% of it.
Yeah, right.
It's heavy. It's like this.
How many horsepower are
there? I don't know. But all the parts are in here, you know, the motor, the transmission, if you will, the hawse hole, this is for triple B chain, and this is the main drive shaft, and this is for rope, of course. This is the part that you'll see above deck.
Nice. Can you hold that up? Or is it too greasy?
It has a manual override, which you probably won't ever use, but... and the motor can be oriented in 90 degree increments, so we're going to have it off to the starboard side so it's not in the way. Anyway, so there's all the goodies for the windlass. It's pretty nice.
Okay. Yeah, give us a lot more deck space also up there.
Well, and I like the way it feeds now, the chain.
Right.
Because anchoring is always a hassle, but if you don't have a good way to get rid of that chain, it's really bad.
Can you talk to us a little bit about finishing up the planking?
Planking.
Last time we were here was end of November, and we still had a couple left.
Okay. So, well, what we've done. Okay. What you always do is once you get down to the shutter, now we're putting the interior and the deck and all that in. You leave this off because if some guy's inside and you're trying to talk to him or whatever, you just can't. It's a cave. So we leave the shutter off until the deck's on and pretty much everything's done. And look, they're over here. These 4 planks are the shutters.
Gotcha. So these are all cut and ready to go.
Cut, filled, fitted, painted, caulking bevels. We've only drilled a small number of the holes just to hold them in place.
Gotcha.
But so they go up one more time to be drilled, and we take them down to make sure we clean up the sawdust or drill dust and all that, and then they go in. That takes less than 1 day to put those in. Or about a day, probably, with the drilling and so forth. But the hull is pretty much fared and sealed. And then we have some shaping left on the 4-foot. We'll wait till all the planking's in to do that. And of course, caulking the bottom.
Caulking the bottom, that's not going to be for a few months. That's before we put it in?
It'll be one of the last things we do.
Okay.
It'll be done about the same time. We may even wait to do it at the boatyard. I don't know. Depends on the weather, depends on a lot of things. Well, like the mooring cleats. See, they sit on the margin board. So we're going to bolt all those in. Once the deck's on, you can't talk to the guy down inside. But with the deck off, one guy by himself can just reach in there and put the bolts on and tighten them up. So stuff like that, a lot of the deck hardware that's in the margin board, we still have to make the margin board for the transom area. And just a bunch of little stuff, you want to make sure you have it done before you put that deck on, because it'll be 10 times as easy. And the interior, as you saw, is mostly in kit form now.
Yeah.
Now we got a little bit to do in the main saloon, but Dave's kind of in there right now. We got to make some new tank supports for the water tank, and we got to make, as you saw, some stuff for the head. Things like the teak pad for the head to sit on, the little mahogany pad for the gauges in the cockpit. We have to make a new cockpit lid. We have to make some donuts, probably 1-inch ply for the propane tanks in the propane locker.
Okay.
Because the other ones were gone, delaminated. And just stuff like that.
We can mount this.
Try to get that mounted today?
Yeah, just get it out of the way. Because I got to thinking about it. Remember we were talking about making this whole mess semi-permanent?
Yeah.
With weird couplings on. I got to thinking about it. I thought, well, done semi-permanent. When will you ever have to take it out? But let's say you do. You just reach up there and take these three legs out. Duh. I'm okay. So we can glue all the PVC together. Just shove it in. Glue it to this. If you ever have to take it out, you unbolt this, just pull it through. Done. So right now, we're gonna go ahead and put them in. See, here comes those helicopters.
Exactly.
Grab your AR-15s, everybody.
Right. I don't think my 38.
Yeah. Yeah, those guys in Oregon. Come on. But it makes a good news story, so what the hell. You might as well.
Did you see Tarp Man?
Tarp Man?
Tarp Man. He's the guy who was there sitting in the chair under the tarp, threatening to shoot anybody who approached him with a gun.
Or in Oregon?
Yeah.
Oh, he's a real pillar of the community.
Oh, yeah. He came down from Utah to show his support.
Well, those Mormons, they need to drink more. Sorry, Jack, I didn't mean that. My brother-in-law's Mormon. Anyway, this stuff here is just a little persnickety stuff you gotta do. I'm just gonna sit this up on deck for now. And when we get a chance, we'll drill these.
All right, so he's
just doing a dry run here.
Dry run. Look at that. And what holds it down? The edge?
This lip right here?
Just the lip.
Yeah, this is gonna go on.
Gotcha, that holds it. Beautiful. Look at that. That's sweet.
Clamp there. Clamp there.
That's the original sink, guys. It's lasted all these years. Beautiful.
Or I mean, until it cured or something?
Yeah, just until it's cured.
I forgot about this thing.
And this is all pinched where we want it.
Right.
C-flex is going to go behind here, here, and then this kind of sits up a little bit, but I can take one of those clamps, it's removable, and pinch that corner down until the C-flex dries.
Oh, I remember now.
Just to hold that down.
The faucet screws hold it down.
Yeah, yeah.
Eventually.
Yeah.
So you're saying you're going to put some glue in here.
I'm going to do glue back here
and
here. I don't expect any glue to stick in here. On the Formica.
Let's do some here.
Okay.
You know why? Because in case the faucet leaks. Because this isn't going anywhere. It's just back there.
Yeah.
Now, do we worry about this at all?
I don't think you're going to get anything to stick to that or...
No. That's how it was. But I think in the faucet area, Yeah.
Oh yeah. I'll do it. Yeah.
And I think let it sit for a couple days. Mm-hmm. Maybe a deep clamp or two.
Yeah.
Big block of wood. Boom, boom. And then whatever.
Yeah. No worries. And when I put the cap on here, I don't need to. Should I seek flex that too or no?
Yes, right here. Just and.
That lips over.
Yeah, and you have to clean it up immediately with alcohol. Because you want lots of it in there.
Yeah.
Right here.
Must be Dave's.
We had an episode of Bonanza.
Victory is.
What?
I need you to drill some holes for me.
What?
I'm gonna put that.
More holes?
That flanging up there.
Okay.
Do we have a trowel for this?
I don't know.
We might have those plastic ones. So I'm gonna center that flange. I marked with tape the depth of the drills. So let's see. There's a 5/16 drill. Just center it as best you can in the hole. And the 3/8 has tape on it too. And we'll put that in and it'll be done. Check.
Wow, okay, so we're all complete now?
Your water heater's all complete other than plumbing.
Right, okay. There she is. Beauty. So Dave, what's next up? Water heater's done, so what's next up?
Just everything, the lighting, all the stuff as they build the interior, I can start finishing up, booking stuff up there. The macerator is going to be, I've decided where it's going, and I'm starting that whole system. And tidying up the wires. I'll run the windlass wires here shortly now that we're ready to put the windlass in.
So you're pretty much back now for the duration?
Yeah.
Great.
Around them.
Yeah, around them, yeah.
And I don't know whether you noticed, it's not completed, but most of your propane stuff's all in, your new tanks and regulator.
Look at that.
All that.
Look at that, new propane, the new box, new tanks, new regulator. Look at that, guys.
To shorten this, how much you want in here?
Let me see how much you're sticking in.
How much do you want sticking in?
I'm gonna start with at least that. We can always cut that. Okay, you got her?
Yeah, right there.
Well, we're gonna need
how much is that flange? Inch and a half in there?
At least. Looks like, yeah, inch and a half. Okay, so. You got it?
Hold it.
Okay. 7 inches. So we need a coupling and about 7 inches of pipe. That's our materials list. What do you think?
I think it's great. I mean, again, another system we never had before.
It's lovely.
So this is way better than what we had. I mean, you know, if it works, it's going to be amazing. It looks like, you know, it's a well constructed idea, and the chain should just start bunching up in the bottom and
It'll slide down.
Slide right down, yeah.
What happens is it goes like this. It slides down, then the next layer comes in, kind of cascades over it.
Yeah.
Until it's point X where there's 4 or 5 layers and it starts to, and there's a lot of room in that bin.
That's great.
So.
Well, 200 feet of chain takes up a good bit of space. If we're going to do 200 feet.
Yeah. Well.
That means we can anchor in about 60. No, we can't. It means we can anchor in maybe 20 feet or 30 feet of water.
Well, the minimum is 3:1. So call it 70 feet.
That's very deep.
Well, yeah. And where's it 70 feet around here you're going to be anchoring? And if you did, it would be not for overnight anyway. It would be, as they say, a lunch break.
Yeah, 70 feet.
Most of these anchorages are 40 or way under. You know, like smugglers, it's like 20,
so if it's,
15.
Okay, so if it's 30, let's say you're anchoring in 30 feet.
Uh-huh.
You'd like to put out, and you want to sleep well.
I'd put 150 feet.
Okay,
but see, the thing is, with chain though.
It's so heavy.
The boat, when it starts to pull on the anchor, it has to lift that chain.
Yeah.
And so the chain acts as a big shock absorber.
Sure.
Whereas a rope, when the boat's pulling on it, it's trying to float. So it's just burn.
Whereas a chain, it has, you have to lift that chain by pulling on this, pulling like this.
Hard.
So, and of course the extra weight of the chain acts to hold the anchor too. It keeps the anchor dug in this way because the chain's going out like this.
Now is that extra pressure on the bow of the boat as well?
Well, the bow of the boat can stand thousands of pounds of downward force because you're pushing straight down on the stem, basically. Yeah. The yank is this way on the windlass, and it's this way and down on the bow. But it's not straight down, it's at an angle. And the stronger the wind blows, the lower that angle gets. So, and with chain, by the way, the boat doesn't bob up and down in the anchors as much because it's trying to lift the chain. Whereas the rope, it just sits there and whatever wave comes along, the boat's going like this. Whereas with chain, it's keeping it from, it's just better. The only downside to all chain, as we talked about, is the weight. And that was the whole point of getting it back here, so that you're well inside the waterline and below the waterline.
All right, so say that again, the system?
It's pretty much dialed in. The geometry's solved, the hole patterns and all that.
Oh, you got the flange in, so you got this thing in.
Yeah.
You got the tips that came through the...
Yeah, I have one other horrifying thought. Hey, Clint.
Yeah?
Could you bring me that windlass pattern, please? I just... Oh yeah, so we're good. This bolt will miss this flange. This bolt will miss the flange, so we're good.
Oh, those are the other bolts. Now those are the actual ones that go down through it.
Yeah, those are the actual windlass mounting bolts.
Gotcha, not the bolts that are just that you put in, which is just for them.
Yeah, so if you think about the load that's on the windlass, it's a horizontal load this way, okay? So this footprint of the windlass, what you're going to be trying to do when you're when that chain's pulling on it is pulling it this way, not up, but this way, a little bit up, but not much. So you can see that by spanning underneath these three deck beams with this plate, 3/4 inch thick sapele, and then the blocking, and then the sub king plank, and then the plywood deck, and then the king plank, with this giant sandwich will keep this from moving at all. Right. So,
but ultimately, it's really being held by the deck beams.
Oh right? Yeah,
they're all tied. And those are.
And also,
what are the condition of these beams? I see
these
this
are
one
really nice. They're in very good shape. That's meaningless.
Yes.
And we're of course right next to a structural bulkhead, okay. So any weird loads and whatnot will be transferred throughout this whole area.
Beautiful.
Which is of course what you want.
It's as strong as it's ever been, ladies and gentlemen.
I think so.
We are rolling. All right, here we go. The installation of the sink. It's a momentous occasion.
Down.
It's going down. He's got it.
That's a concoction of whale blubber, mayonnaise, and linseed oil. It'll protect stainless steel at the same time being waterproof.
The noise around, it's such a quiet neighborhood.
Well, you have the sheriff's helicopters, the armed protesters.
The truck backing up.
The San Bernardino Symphony.
That's the Ventura Symphony out there.
Currently, apparently, the Ventura Avenue Philharmonic.
The Ventura Avenue Philharmonic. That's fucking awesome. I'm using that. That's one of our sections this time. Oh, yeah. He's got the
floor
edging in.
Yeah, you guys can buy this. It's not going to dry anytime soon.
Oh, that's a fast cure. Oh, my God.
The Philharmonic is wrapping it up. It's the third movement.
What I need.
Clint, look at that. It's freaking beautiful.
Galley.
Look at that. There she is. Beautiful. The original countertop, all rebuilt below.
Nice new fridge down there.
Beautiful new fridge and whole really new kitchen. New galley.
Thank you.
Marrying the old and the new in excellent fashion.
So those old world.
Those need to be all screwed in. Yeah.
Old world styling with modern technology.
If they're not gonna do that, then I can try to hear my wires.
Set up a little clamp situation here.
So just hold that middle down for us.
Yeah. Look at the technique. Look at the technique.
Yeah.
And now you're making it even harder for me to get in there. Good thing I can fit underneath there. I don't think I need to get back in there much more, but.
All right, well, things are looking amazing, so I'm taking off for 3 weeks. What do you think will be happening over the next 3 weeks? I know you'll take lots of photographs.
We have an armed standoff here.
Oh, another armed protester.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Jeez, what the hell is that?
It's a Bowie knife. No, it's a machete. Machete.
Wow.
U.S. Marine Corps, 1943.
I use it for carving out planks.
It's a Chumash ads.
That's some serious shit.
So anyway, 3 weeks from now, well, we're going to bolt on the mooring cleats, that block. We got to put that block in, we keep forgetting. And hoses and wires and stuff that would be a real pain if we didn't if we had the deck on.
Yeah, sure.
We'll finish the anchor chain hose pipe situation. And gosh, that little cabinet, putting all this stuff back together we've already made.
That's great.
Tank supports for the holding tank, the water tank. And we're gonna have to make some supports for Dave for the water maker.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, you remember that water pump that was in the settee? Right in the settee.
There was some kind of bilge pump.
It was a fresh water pump.
Oh, yeah.
Well, now that we took that other water tank out, I think we can put that under the cabin sole.
Okay.
So you get a little room, a little storage in there.
Okay.
And Clint just put the sink and countertop in the
galley.
That's beautiful. We've got to put the faucets in, so those little soffits. Gosh,
there's a lot of little stuff to do before you really start getting onto the deck.
And as soon as you put the deck on, it's going to get dark in there.
Yeah, it already is dark.
It's getting darker. And stuff like the base for the toilet, things like that. Just stuff.
So basically, as much as you possibly can.
Exactly.
Okay.
In other words, once you put the deck on, you're putting the deck on.
Right.
Whether you like it or not. And other than that, that's about it. We've got all the stuff figured out. We should have the interior done by the time you get back, close to it. Because, you know how it is. You have to make this piece, and before you put it in, you got to seal it.
Oh, yeah. No.
Let it dry.
I think we all know the process now.
Put some varnish on it. Right, yeah. Let it dry some more, put some more varnish in, put it in. So stuff like that. But we should be really close on almost ready to put that deck on when you get back. Got to make the piece on the stern, the little cap piece. Some minor repairs here and there, fill a few holes. Other than that, I think by the end of the month, certainly, we should be pretty much ready to start putting the deck down.
Okay. You feeling pretty good about the progress, about this last?
Yeah. And we're leaving the refrigerator out because we have that one more shutter plank we've got to put in. There's an area down there we have to reach to put the bolts in. And with the fridge in, you can't do it. But where the shutter plank is, it's pretty much accessible everywhere, I think, for bolting. So.
That looks beautiful. Beautiful.
Yeah.
We'll see you next time. 3 weeks.
Okay.